Well, I want to thank everyone for coming this morning. I'm State Senator Jeff Klein, and I'm very proud to be joined here by, I think, a very effective coalition, all on the same page to create new jobs and help New York's veterans. I do want to introduce Senator David Carlucci, who's the sponsor of the legislation. Another companion piece of legislation is introduced by Senator Greg Ball, and I know we have with us Senator Malcolm Smith and Senator David Carlucci. We're announcing, I think, a very important initiative that we hope will be a win-win for both statewide businesses and some of New York's best qualified job seekers. Just in the way of background, one of the things that the Independent Democratic Conference did over the last 2 years is something that we call thought raisers. We traveled around the state. We held meetings in our respective districts, sometimes at the same time, with a singular purpose. To hear from businesses and other groups around our state. And one of the things that we found when we met with small businesses was they were looking for ways to create jobs. When we met with American Legion halls and veterans groups all around the state, we found out that they need jobs. So we thought this was sort of the perfect marriage to put together a coalition of businesses, small and large, to help America's bravest. And one of the things that we found was quite startling. According to data from the U.S. Bureau of Statistics, which has finally been released for the first time today, New York State currently has a total of 8,000 unemployed post 9/11 veterans. These are veterans who served our country in Afghanistan and Iraq, and their unemployment rate is an astounding 10.7%. Now let's take a step back. When men and women go overseas to fight for their country, I think it's an absolute disgrace that when they come back, there isn't a job waiting for them. So today, I think we're putting together that very, very important coalition of businesses and veterans to see what we can do about not only creating jobs in New York State, which all businesses want to be able to do, but to reduce that unemployment rate of New York's veterans. So I'd like to introduce the sponsor of the legislation, Senator Carlucci of Westchester and Rockland counties. Senator Carlucci.
Hey, thanks. Thank you, Senator Klein, and I want to thank everybody that's here with us today. During my time in the State Senate, I've had the privilege of serving on the Veterans Committee in the Senate. And one of the tools that's helped me is I've set up a veterans advisory group in the Hudson Valley where we meet every couple of weeks with veterans from all different age groups, and we talk about the issues, the concerns that are facing them in front of them in their daily lives every day. And one of the things that we've decided is we set the goal to lower the unemployment rate for veterans in New York State. Unfortunately, the statistics that Senator Klein just mentioned aren't just in New York State. And we have a graph over there that shows county by county. Some counties suffer a higher unemployment rate for veterans, higher than others. So this was a goal of our advisory committee. We said we have to do what we can to lower the unemployment rate in New York. And we believe we could have the lowest unemployment rate for veterans of any state by pushing smart legislation like this. Senator Ball, Senator Grassanti have also sponsored legislation similar to this. And we decided and we believe that by putting the best of those bills together, making it more comprehensive, more targeted, we believe that it can be more effective. So what does this legislation do? This legislation, Jobs for Heroes, is a way to lower the unemployment rate for veterans, and not just any job, but good paying jobs. So we're offering up to a $10,000 tax credit for any employer that hires an unemployed veteran that's been discharged from service after 9/11. So we're targeting younger veterans who suffer from some of the highest unemployment rates. Give employees the tax credit of up to $10,000, so it's 10% of their salary. So for example, if they're earning $100,000 a year, that employer would get a $10,000 tax credit. If they hire a veteran at $60,000 a year, that employer would get a $6,000 tax credit. And we incentivize it even more for disabled veterans. So a disabled veteran would receive up to 15% of their salary, up to a $15,000 tax credit. So we believe that this legislation targeting our younger veterans will really do the job in lowering the unemployment rate for veterans in New York State. The last place we should be sending our veterans that are coming back from Afghanistan today is to an unemployment line. So I'm so glad to be standing with my esteemed colleagues in the Senate, and I know that working together, we'll be able to pass this important legislation. Now I'd like to turn it over to Senator Ball, who will talk a little bit more about this legislation.
Thanks, Dan. Well, I want to thank you for being here, and if we can just take a moment first to the veterans who are here and to all of our vets, if you wouldn't mind standing up so we can salute you and applaud you for your service. When we look at the unemployment rate in New York State, but throughout this country, service-disabled vets specifically have typically twice the unemployment rate of the rest of the population. And when we look at into the eyes of those who return from places like Iraq and Afghanistan, when you look into those eyes, you see the pain and what had to be endured for our freedom. There is nothing that we can do that is more important than making sure that these vets not only have a job, but have meaningful employment that allow them not only to get a paycheck, but to actually provide opportunities to their employers. These vets are not looking for a handout in any way. What these vets are looking for is an opportunity to excel. When we look at the economy today, it's a tough economy, but there's something else going on too when we look at our educational system and the ability to match human capital to the needs of the current economy. These vets who are returning from overseas have the exact skill sets necessary to get this economy going, to take that meaningful employment, and give that employer the skills and the employees that they need. There is nothing more important that we can do in the next few months than to pass this legislation. And I'll tell you, on the tax credit side, it was done by the Senate previously. We've got to make sure that the Assembly make it a priority in the same way. And on the service-disabled veteran side, all we're looking to do is do what many other states have already done. The federal government already has a set aside, and New York State, once again, has to be a leader to take care of those who have taken care of us. Thank you so much.
I'd also like to recognize Senator Diane Savino, who's with us today, representing parts of Staten Island and Brooklyn. Next up is another friend of veterans in the state Senate, someone who also is taking this issue on and also has a piece of legislation involving tax credits for veterans, Senator Mark Grisanti.
Morning, everybody. You know, it's a great day when you have a legislative body that gets together, both in a coalition with the IDC, legislation that I sponsored, legislation that Greg Ball had sponsored, legislation now that Senator Carlucci has, where you take the best of those pieces of legislation and you put it together. Ladies and gentlemen, the numbers of veterans, both disabled, that are coming back is mind-boggling. There is going to be droves, and we have to make sure that the jobs are there. And the best way to do it is make sure we have these tax credits. We also have to make sure that there's mechanisms in place, and they are in this legislation, that the businesses hire and keep the veterans, that they just don't hold on to a veteran for 6 months, get the tax credit, and then let them go. I mean, there's very stringent specifications on what needs to be done in order to protect the veterans, both those coming back, both those that are disabled, to make sure that they continue in the workforce and have the jobs that are available. So I'm proud to stand here today with my colleagues and our partners to get this legislation done, and absolutely, we got to get this pushed through the Assembly. As Senator Ball said, we had legislation before. This is the best of the best, and it's an honor to push us forward for the veterans across the state. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I do want to recognize some of the individuals we have with us today who aren't going to speak, but I want to really thank them because they're a very, very important part of this partnership. We have with us Ted Patricus of the Retail Council. Michael Rosen of the Food Industry Alliance. William Mangione, Senior Vice President in Drexel Hamilton, a financial services firm in New York City. Joe Krudler, a member of 101 Airborne Army Unit who served in Iraq and is currently training at Drexel Hamilton. Nick Vow, Public Affairs Manager, Albany Colony Regional Chamber of Commerce. Tim Ostrowski, President of National Federation of Federal Employees, Local 2109, currently employs 300 veterans at the Waterville Elite Arsenal. Charles Burks, Director of the Albany County Veterans Service Bureau. Jonathan Parsons, Saratoga RPC. Let's give him a hand. And someone from my neck of the woods in Bronx County, a very successful businessman and a community leader, Bob Beter, from Westchester Square Plumbing Supply. Thank you, Bob. Next up is an owner of a very important business that very effectively serves and creates jobs in Westchester County. Right now, they are the single largest employer in the great city of Yonkers. I'm proud that we have with us today Tim Rooney, the owner of Yonkers Raceway and Empire City Casino.
Thank you. It's a real honor to be here. You know, from an employer's perspective, look, I think all of us want to do the right thing. And oftentimes in this economy, it hasn't been easy, you know. But, you know, as the largest employer in Westchester County, we have 1,200 employees now. And, you know, certainly we're always looking for qualified employees. And, you know, when you think about the opportunity that's there and what the service that our veterans have provided this country and the debt that we owe them, you know, it's just a matter of doing the right thing. And this legislation, you know, pieces like this, and especially this legislation, as you described, provides, you know, the best of the best of the previous ideas that have been there, providing for tax credits. You know, sometimes businesses need that added incentive to, they want to do the right thing, but it's not always easy. So this type of legislation really enables them to take that extra step. We applaud the members of the legislature, the members of the Senate that are behind me, Senators Klein and Carlucci, for advancing this legislation, and you know, we're happy to be behind it. We've sponsored veterans jobs fairs, and we look forward to utilizing the incentives that are provided here, helping small businesses to sort of come with us to provide the opportunities to veterans that they should have. So thank you very much.
Next up is Chuck Tobin, the CEO of Focus Technologies in Albany, who employs 12 service-disabled veterans. Chuck?
Thank you, Senator Klein. Back in 2008, we hired our first veteran, and the initiative that he showed, the leadership that he showed at our company made such a difference that since then we've made a commitment to hiring veterans. Currently, actually, it's 15 now, Senator. And but over the history of our company, we've had 50 veterans working for us, and some are still there, and some have used our company as a stepping stone to other opportunities. This legislation, very much like the federal tax credit, will help us to be able to buy more equipment, to be able to build our business, by making the best advantage of our capital, and we hope it passes because we know that we're going to still hire veterans every time we need a new person. So thank you, Senator.
I want to thank all of my colleagues and everyone who came out today.